Hi lovelies, it's me, Simply Sherry, making home and entertaining simple. Today I'm going to show you our entryway closet and how we have now organized it. So this is our front door, it's double doors, and then this is our entryway, and I think it's a pretty decent sized foyer. And then there's a couple steps down, and then that is our entryway closet. Here to the left I have hooks for guests' coats and hats and umbrellas. I've had this system for a few years and it works out very well. When the recent repairs were done to our house, the entryway closet inside got messed up because the flood had come into there also. So it's new drywall. This is also a new door and then new hardware there and new paint. Also some new door jams. So I wanted to show you that we have updated the organization just a little bit. The major change in here is that these hooks, there are four there, and then another two, and they're kind of like one above and one below. So they used to be here on the back of the door, and since this is a new door, Cicely and I had decided that we don't need to use the back of the door anymore for organization because we did declutter here a lot. She probably got rid of like four pairs of shoes, a couple sweaters, and whatever she has left as far as outdoor jackets and sweaters, I think she has about three or four of them. They're now in her closet, so we didn't need to use this anymore for her stuff. Also, I had moved the hats from our command center that were in a bin, and I put them all here. So these are all my hats. There are eight of them, and that's kind of the limit that I've set because there are eight hooks up there. And then for my husband, we decluttered his hats. I probably got rid of four hats. He probably got rid of five or six. Those are enough for six hats. So you can see that it's a double hook. So right now he has five. So he does have space for one more. And then this is kind of a weird angle in my entryway closet. It's kind of like a V, it goes in there. So I can utilize the space on this wall. What I've done is just to put a hook there, and that's where we keep our umbrella. If I want to put another umbrella, I could definitely put it here, but I do have an umbrella in each glove compartment in our car, so I think that's good for now because that is three umbrellas. And I do like that there is a little bit of floor space now. I've had the shoe organizer before, and basically all of my daughter's shoes are here. She just basically wears the same shoes every day. They go right here. They're a pair of Converse. These are her volleyball shoes and the knee pad. So volleyball season is done, so she'll just keep it there. Here are some boots, sandals for the summer. Oh no, they're Mossimo, they're from Target. And then these are a new pair of shoes that we also got for her for the beginning of the school year. Someone just gave this to her, so she actually has a lot of gym shoes. And then these are Converse that she got last Christmas, and they have kind of the fur in it, so she wears that during the colder season. And then she has some swim hiking shoes here. She does have another pair of shoes. They're hiking boots, which we keep in the garage with the other gear that we have for camping and hiking. These are her indoor slippers, and then slippers that she can wear outside. All of my closets have this like immense space that goes up there. So I've never been able to customize the closets yet because that, you know, would require a budget. So for now, I just try to utilize the vertical space that's here. And these are summer hats. I don't have to access that throughout the year, so it's fine right there. I can grab it, and to put it back, I just grab the step stool in the kitchen to put it back on the hook there. And then here are a couple more hats that fit perfectly onto this shelf. If I wanted to fit a third hat, I could put it this way and put the third one here, but I don't wanna feel like I have to get a third hat. So I like to keep it like that, and I think it's displayed well, it's not crowded, and it keeps it neat and tidy. These are all my jackets and sweaters and outerwear. There are 25 of them. And because this is a small closet, I do use the thin velvet hangers. And trust me, I have gone through this probably about five times this past year, and I cannot let go of any of these. Yeah, I just added one. And then everything I've had for at least a year, if not years, or even a decade. I have this trench coat that I have had forever. I love it. I'm never gonna let it go, probably. Here is another trench coat, raincoat. It's a navy blue. And then here are some jackets. I think I got both of these from Costco, and it's just the right type of material where for the weather here, it's not, you know, too much, because trust me, it doesn't get that cold. Maybe it gets to the low 40s. And this faux leather jacket is more for dressing up. I use this one all the time, especially when I travel. It's a great jacket because it keeps me warm in those, you know, cold airports or the cold restaurants, and it has a lot of pockets. Here's another one, just a little bit thinner. And I've had these for years. They're very durable. They're awesome. They're very comfortable. So these are the different styles I have. This one actually is a hoodie and with some reflective stuff on there. Here's just a different color. And then this is a really lightweight one. I love this during the spring. And then I have this jean shirt. I've had these for years and they're just a little bit different as far as style and a little bit different as far as color. Another kind of sweatshirt hoodie. This one I wear a lot actually. It's a longer sweater there, kind of like that open sleeve. And this one has the long sleeve. Can you tell I love vests? Puffy vests. This actually has a hoodie. I gotta go find that. You can see it's like suede and faux fur. This one is faux leather. Another one's faux fur and kind of like a sweater in the back. This is a brown faux leather. And this actually has a detachable collar that has faux fur. I gotta go find that too. And then this one I love. I wish I could wear it more often. But it's a puffy white one from the Calvin Klein kind of sports athletic store. And then that's what it looks like when the door is wide open. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you're new to my channel, please hit the subscribe button. I'd love to have you on this journey with me to making home and entertaining simple. Please leave a comment below and let me know what you put in your entryway closet. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye. I'm waiting long for you. So be my princess for life.